now start the meeting. Any apologies present? I've got one, which is Jean Stapleton, who's not well, unfortunately. Anybody else?
Councillor John Hale and Councillor Ian Lewis have been substituted by Ian Lewis and Bruce Berry.
Members' code of conduct, declarations of interest from anybody on any of the items which are on the agenda tonight. Christina.
I'm also sorry for President Brown.
Councillor. Thank you. Can I also ask all members present to declare that nobody present is subject to a party whip tonight? Agreed?
Agreed.
Thank you. Item 3, can I now have the minutes to sign from the last meeting? And can all members agree that the minutes, if there anything matters arising from the minutes? And do we all acknowledge that they are a true record of our last meeting? Fourth item on the agenda, residence parking and scrutiny review. Now, Jean chaired this meeting, which was attended by Dave Mitchell and Chris Blakely. And I think having read the report, it's a good report, and Jean was going to say that she'd like to thank the officers who took part in the review and for the contribution of Dave Mitchell and Chris Blakely. But I think Dave would like to say a few words.
Yes, thank you.
Can I finish, Dave, please?
Yes, thank you.
And Chris, who's sitting at the back there, would like to come forward as well and say a few words. So as long as there's nobody on the committee who objects to Chris coming forward, I'm sure there isn't. If Dave, you say a few words, and if anyone's got any questions. I think what we'll do is if Dave says what he wants to say about the review, and then if I call Chris forward, and then Chris can stay seated where he is, and then if any members have got any questions that they'd like to ask of either Dave or Chris, we can do it that way if that's agreed. Agreed? Dave, thank you.
Thank you, Chair. Yes, this was a piece of work that was requested. It's something that needed doing on an annual, more regular basis. It's quite a few years since the last time the authority looked at the residence parking scheme. We had to really look to date, and we needed to look at a lot of different issues. As you quite rightly said, Jean and Chris and I looked at quite a lot of different information. We had residents come in and explain to us problems they were having in certain areas and what we needed to do as an authority to address problems that they were having in certain areas. The criteria itself, the old criteria and the modern criteria, are completely different. In that basically the numbers alone, because in certain areas in parts of heavily developed areas, residential areas, problems will occur, but residents wouldn't have the opportunity to come forward with a petition to the selectmen, to the council, addressing the residents' parking. So, we've looked at all those different issues and the effects of the standards that we've got already, those areas that already have residence parking scheme, and we tried to come with the easiest possible way to bring in everything into line. So members, if you've read the report, you'll understand the reasons for the recommendations that we put forward as a group. And I hope it was accepted by the selectmen. I would add that the hard work on by the officers was absolutely excellent. Given that we really pressurised them to give lots of information in a short period of time.
Thanks, Dave. Chris, would you like to come forward, please? Thank you.
Thank you, Chair.
is coming up after.
Can I just have clarification, please, on Manor Lane in this car? Where is Manor Lane, please?
I think it would be better if you ask the officer when he comes forward.
Yeah, it's a road post, it's the faces of school.
The members, Christina.
Sorry, Chair, I mean, it's just up the road that way.
It's by this car for Army.
Yeah, it's right on the side. And it's.
I know.
It's basically just residents parking, people going to the school.
Most down to Hackett, right?
Yeah.
Thanks, Dave. Keith, could you? Thank you. Now, can I just say to members that I would hope we've all read the report. So rather than Keith, if you just want to give us a very brief outline, and then if members have got any questions, there's already been a couple of issues raised here. I think the big one is how it's going to be implemented. And Keith, thank you.
Thank you, through you, Chair. As has been mentioned, this report comes out of a meeting of your committee back in July last year, when we decided to set up the task and finish group to look at the resident parking policy, because it had become apparent since 2007, when this policy was last reviewed, that residents were having some difficulty in actually complying with the criteria in the policy. So much so that there were no actual schemes introduced under the current policy since it was introduced in 2007. The only schemes that have been implemented since then were Manor Lane was mentioned, Heath Drive out of Hessel, and the residential roads around Victoria Road in New Brighton. Each of those three didn't actually meet the criteria for 2007, but there were other issues that were taken account of through either a cabinet decision, a planning committee decision, or again a cabinet decision on the capital programme. So as I say, it became obvious that it was very difficult for residents to meet that criteria. So as part of the business of the panel, they had residents in, some of the residents we've been dealing with over the years, to discuss the difficulties that they had with the criteria. And obviously, we looked then at the criteria to see what amendments could be made to make it less onerous on residents actually to gather the evidence that they need to present to us so that we can take forward the requests. We also looked at the sort of the inflexibility of the existing criteria in terms of for the smaller schemes, as mentioned by Councillor Blakely, there's no real allowance for officer discretion, although there may be circumstances that need to be, that other circumstances over and above the criteria that need to be taken into account. So this report that's before you today also covers that possibility as well for some officer discretion under certain circumstances. The report that's before you also talks about the historic schemes, because the schemes introduced since 2007 have all been chargeable. So it's a very small proportion of residents, but they do pay for their permits, whereas the vast majority of permits that are out there are currently free of charge in the historic schemes. So there's an issue there around obviously, they're free to the users, but they do actually, there is a cost involved in processing the permits, and that's meant through the revenue budget generally, or pays for whether you benefit from the scheme or not. So there's an issue there around it being equitable between an existing historic scheme owners and new schemes, and also other ratepayers. And then again, that's covered by one of the recommendations in the report before you. So basically, that's the report. So if there's any questions anyone would like to ask, I'm happy to try and take them.
Any questions? Gerry?
Thanks. Keith, you may remember about
circumstances such as that, then obviously if there's no appetite, I mean, we wouldn't, under the existing criteria, we wouldn't take forward a proposal for residents parking unless there's at least 80% support from the residents themselves, which obviously there wasn't from the residents of West Cllr. In addition to that, there was significant objection in terms of that petition that was submitted. And we're not proposing to change that 80% requirement in terms of having support from the residents themselves for the scheme. I wouldn't want to bulldoze a scheme in on residents, you know, force them, you know, that's not what we're here for. So we do
need to... What do you think has changed in the 10 years? If the 80% were against it, why might they now vote for it?
It's not just that area though, it's all areas around the borough. Yeah. I mean, we do get, you know, in the interim since then, we have had requests from some residential roads in West Cllr for residents parking. And we've gone back to them to explain the criteria to them, and they've not been able to get that 80% support. But there are other areas around the borough where that 80% support is apparent. But there are these other aspects of the criteria, such as the scale of the scheme, this sort of thing. So I think I do appreciate that there are areas of Wirral that won't entertain a residence parking scheme. That's fine. You know, we're not proposing to put residence parking in areas where residents don't want residence parking. It's only for those locations where residents actually want the scheme that we're looking at this, and we're looking to introduce some officer. Discretion into the process. But as I say, 80% to me is a cut-off point. I wouldn't want to, you know, wouldn't want to force a resident parking scheme on any particular residents. In terms of the other question, which was around shops, there is in the criteria, one of the questions we ask, or one of the statements we make, is that local businesses shouldn't be disadvantaged by a resident parking scheme. So for example, in the likes of Liscard, we've got in some of the roads in Liscard, we have 90 non-permit holders, which is sufficient to allow them to go into the shops and do their shopping and come back out. What the resident parking scheme does is it prevents the people who either park there to go and work in the shops, you know, they can park either further afield or they can park in public car parks. And it also prevents, in some locations, the issues around commuters. So it prevents people parking all day, jumping on a bus and going over to Liverpool, this sort of issue. So we are mindful that, you know, we don't want to disadvantage businesses, and we make sure that the residents who apply for schemes, if the issues around shop